A very good morning to all of you. Like my earlier videos on stereochemistry, this is in continuation with that. So here also we are discussing few practice problems on R and S configuration and how you identify. So the first question is, classify 2S, 3S, 2,3 dichloropentane and 2R, 3R, 2,3 dichloropentane as enantiomer, distereoisomer, conformational isomers, constitutional isomers or identical. So the answer to this question is enantiomer. So as you can see to the question that 2s and 3s, the configuration at the second and the third carbon atom is s, whereas in the other isomer it is r. So they are mirror images to each other and hence the answer to this question is enantiomer. Now the next problem comes, classify 2r, 3s, 2,3 dichlorobutane and 2s, 3r, 2,3 dichlorobutane as enantiomer, distereoisomers, conformational isomers, constitutional isomers, or whether they are identical to each other. So as you can see at 2R, 3S, so the other isomer has 2S and 3R. So they both are similar, they are identical to each other. So the answer to this question is that the compounds are identical to each other. So now I go down to the third question, classify 2R, 3R, 2,3 dichlorobutane and 2S, 3S, 2,3 dichlorobutane as enantiomer, distereoisomer, conformational, constitutional, or whether they are identical. So you are seeing that in one of the figure it is R and in the other it is S. So the answer to this question is enantiomers. As you can see in the previous slide in this question that at one of the isomer is R and at the same identical mirror image it is S and hence they are not superimposable on each other. Therefore the answer to the question is enantiomer. So another question is, identify the number of stereoisomers for 3-bromo-2,4,5 trichlorohexane. So you have let me know that how many stereoisomers will be formed. So 2,4,5 trichloro, that means at the 2, 4th and 5th position is chlorine. At the 3rd position it is bromine. That means you can just see the answer to this question is 16 isomers. And 16 isomers, as you can see over here, 2 to the power 4. That means the number of asymmetric carbon atoms you can see is 4. 2 to the power 4 is the formula to calculate the number of stereoisomers. So asymmetric carbon atom is at second position, the third position which is carrying the bromine, the fourth and the fifth position which is both carrying the chlorine atom. So 2 to the power 4, 2 to the power n will make out to be 16 stereoisomers. So the answer to the correct answer to this question is 16. Now there's another question as to define meso compound. So a meso compound is an achiral molecule, or whether it has a plane of symmetry. A meso compound has chiral carbons, or all of these above points are correct. So you can see that all of these points are correct because a meso compound has chiral carbon atoms and is achiral, and it also has plane of symmetry. That means within the molecule, if you have make a line or draw a mirror, the upper half of the molecule will be similar to the lower half of the molecule. That does not mean that it does not have chiral carbons. It has chiral carbon atoms, and due to the presence of the plane of symmetry, the molecule turns out to be achiral. As rotation due to the upper half of the molecule will be cancelled due to rotation of the lower half of the molecule. So there's another set of questions you can just see. That identify a pair of distereoisomers. You have to tell me A and whether A and B are distereoisomers or A and D are distereoisomers or B or C or none of these are there. So as you can see in the 1 and the 2 position of the carbon, and you just see the mirror image that in the B, the position of is reverse in the first, like if you count it from below, then the first number of carbon atom will be this. So in the first position, bromine and chlorine, so chlorine on the left hand side, and in the second figure B also similar position here, and but in the first this position, the number 2 position, it is reverse. So as you all know that in distereoisomers the configuration is preserved at one of the carbon atoms, chiral carbon atoms, and it is reversed at the other carbon atom. So now if you look down at A and D, if you look at A and D, then you are just seeing that at both the carbon atoms the configuration is reverse. And if you compare B and C, as the question says, in B and C also they are mirror images to each other. So they are not mirror images, therefore they will be B and C will be enantiomers. So the since the question is about distereoisomers, so we can see that A and B are distereoisomers. Why? Because at one carbon atom, chiral carbon atom, the configuration is preserved, and at the other chiral carbon atom, it is reversed. So the answer is A. Correct answer is A and B. So there's another question: identify a pair of enantiomers. So similar question. So like if you can see that Br, BrCl, the A and B. If you look at A and B, so they are distereoisomers. If you look at B and C, that means since they're enantiomers, that means they should be mirrored image to each other. So you can see B and C are mirrored images to each other. So the correct answer to this question is B and C. So now we go down to another question. Identify a meso compound. So A, B, C, D point is A and D are meso. So you can see the figure A, that if you draw a mirror from in between, then you see that the upper half and the lower half are mirror images to each other. In D, it is in question of a structure B, it is not so. In C also, if you draw a mirror in between, it will not be mirror image. Whereas in D, it will be there. Like if you draw a mirror in between, so the upper half will be the mirror image of the lower half. So A and D is the correct answer, that A and D are meso compounds. So compare the physical properties of distereoisomers. They have different physical properties, or whether they have same physical properties or cannot be determined, or whether they have the same chemical properties. So the answer to this question is they have different physical properties, such as melting point, boiling point, that will be different in case of distereoisomer. So this is now the end of the chapter, and I've discussed the problems earlier also. So thank you so much for joining and helping me out to make the concept of stereochemistry more clear. And please look into my further videos where I'll be presenting to you demonstrations. So do like, subscribe my channel, Dr. Rupali Sethi, Chemistry Made Easy. Thank you so much. Thank you.